Okay, so hello guys, and in this tutorial I'll be showing you how to upload your website files to the server. So finally, maybe probably you've heard about the domain and the server from one of the hosting services, name it like Namecheap, Bluehost, or one actually that is very common, it's it Hostgator, then and they go at it. So assuming that you've bought your server and you want to upload your website files to that server and host them with it, so now I'm just going to show you a quick method that is kind of simple to host your upload your files from your computer from a computer drive to the server, that is of course on the cPanel. So I kind of have already bought my server with Namecheap, and I also bought a domain. So this is my domain with Namecheap, and I already have a server bought. So I'm just going to go into the server and show you how I'm going to upload the files very fast, and in just a few minutes we will be in air, on air, and we will be able to see the website being published. So let's go. Number one, you have to click on actually you don't have to follow this because I'm just accessing my server right now. Probably if you have Namecheap you can follow the same steps, but if you have on Bluehost or GoDaddy, probably you'll see a button a button like this that will say go to cPanel, and that will be your link to your cPanel. So in this tutorial I'm assuming that for example you already have access to your cPanel, so I'm gonna go ahead and click on my cPanel and enter my cPanel and see how I'm going to start. So redirecting you to cPanel. So I'm also assuming that whether you're on Bluehost or GoDaddy, you're already accessing your cPanel. So let's start off. Now, number one, you have to kind of scroll down and look for the files, because we're going to be uploading files to the server. So look for files, then file manager. Now here where we have file manager, it's where you have to click on file manager, and the file manager will open. Now also again, I'm assuming that you have your website files already prepared on your computer, on your drive, and you've already built your website and it's compiled together, but on your computer your asset files, and you just want to upload them to the server and make sure that they are public. So finally you publish it to the internet. So now I'm already in my file manager. You can see that I already have some assets, some files are already uploaded in, but I'm kind of going to first delete all of them to make sure that we have nothing here, because remember we are uploading a very new website. Assuming that we have nothing in our cPanel. And also you have to note that in this folder or directory where I am is actually a public.html folder. So if you want anything to be public, like if you have anything on your server, for example a file, or for example an HTML file, to be public it must be uploaded in the public HTML folder by default. So by default the server comes with a number of folders for logos, mails, then this one I just created it myself, but anyways you will also have the one for FTP. And also now this about this FTP, in the next tutorial I will be doing a video about how to upload a website through HTTP to your server, or to your server through the cPanel, but uploading through the HTTP route, but SSL and the rest. But we are most interested in the public HTML folder, because whatever we're going to upload here, which is a website, it will have to show publicly on the internet. So in order to have the index file or the website, or the index file of the website, to be public, to be whereby somebody can search for it on Google and he finds it, it must be uploaded in the public HTML folder. So let's go ahead and open our folder. So my folder is already open, just like I showed you. I deleted everything that I had. So assuming that you have a public HTML empty folder, you have to go ahead and upload. So you click on upload, and it will load. It will bring you a page where you will say where you have to drop your files that you want to upload. So you, in any case, we have our files on a computer. For example, you have your files already stored in a computer, so you kind of have to go ahead and click on it, then it takes to the computer, and then you upload the file. But now let me kind of take you back to my computer and show you how I prepare my website files to be ready for upload on the server. Now, number one, according to my method, I normally compile my folders, I mean my files, into a zip folder, and I upload a zip folder at once. So here we are. I'm gonna be using this folder here, so it's already zipped. I kind of want to first unzip it and we start it afresh, such that you can follow, because I'm assuming that you already have the folder that is actually not zipped. So we are starting from this folder that is not zipped to first zipping it, then after zipping it we upload it on the server. When it is zipped, then after uploading it to the public HTML on the server, we unzip the contents so that they can power into the public HTML folder when they are not zipped in any folder. So in that case, that's how you can be able to access them, the files in the public domain. So here we are, we have our folder called page 12, and this folder contains all the website pages and assets that we used, the files, you know, pictures. You can see these are all my website files that I've been coding over the time. So these are my HTML and index pages. Now you have the contact us, blah blah, academics, blah, and you must have the index file, because as you're uploading files to the public HTML, the public HTML only goes for the index file. So if it doesn't see the index file, then it probably won't, it won't be able to publish that website. So you have to have the index file by default in your HTML folder. So I already have the public, I mean the index file, index.html file already. So now I have all these files of mine. Now what I want to do is to zip. You first control all, you control all, then right click, and then send them to a zipped folder. So that's kind of a method that is actually a little bit faster. But let me kind of create a separate folder that is that's going to make it a little bit clearer. New, create a new folder, and in this folder we shall call it new website. So this is our folder that is not zipped. So we open our new website. This is where we are going to paste our website files. Then we go ahead and see how we can zip them, then finally upload them to the server. Now okay, now they are already pasted. Number one, you control all, highlight all the files, then right click, and then send them to a zipped folder. So you have to compress to zip file. So you click on compress to zip file, and it will go ahead to compress or to zip the files. And after zipping the files, I'm very sure it will show you that after zipping, it creates a folder called page 5 and puts every file of yours into that folder. So you just have to press enter to confirm the name, and when you go ahead and open the folder, it will show you that it contains all the files. Now this is where we're going to pick our folder from, inside here. Okay, now we go back to our server. Where exactly? This is where we were. Now we are preparing to upload the files, I mean the zipped file, from the computer drive to the server. So you you click on select file, and it will kind of bring your computer explorer, file explorer. So you go ahead and look for where you have your files. Remember, we created a new folder on the disk called was on desktop. Okay, so the folder is here, and we called it new website. So you open the folder, and we are most interested in this page 5 for zipped folder. So when you click on the page 5, we just kind of you can either double click and it will upload automatically, or you single click or highlight it, then go ahead and click on open. So once you click on open, it will upload the files, a full zipped folder to the server, and specifically to the public HTML file. You can see selecting the file that you want to upload to the /that/public HTML. So whatever we're uploading is going direct to the public HTML file on a server. So it's done uploading 100%. So we no longer need this page. We go back to our public HTML directory. I think it hasn't loaded. You just have to reload and the file will be present here, the one that we've just uploaded. I think you can see page 5 has already been uploaded here. So you click on the file, right click, and then extract, such that it extracts everything that it contains to the public HTML. So you can see everything is now revealed to the inside the public HTML. So assuming that now we already have the index in, so the website will be automatically reading the HTML. So now you go ahead and access your domain. Try to access your domain on Google. Remember, our domain was mltsj. This is my domain in my case. In your case, if you have your domain, you go ahead and load it in your browser, and you must have some good internet connection. So finally, my website is up and it's running. So this is how the website looks. I've just finished programming it. So finally it's done, and it's already online and anyone can access it at any time. So I think that's all, guys. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next tutorials. Now in the next story, I will leave the link in the description. I will put in the link in the description for the next tutorial, whereby I'm gonna have to teach you how to create a custom email using cPanel. So when you're in a cPanel, you can create custom emails for your company or for your personal use. So I will be going ahead and recording another short video that will show you how to create an email account and configure it, and how you're going to be logging in, if at all you were doing it for a client, how you're going to send it to the client and explain to you how to log in, things like that, using the RoadTube, the hardcore, everything. So for this tutorial, thanks for watching. I think I will see you in the next tutorial. Just subscribe in the below button, please, and also like the video, thumbs up, and also turn on the notifications for new and upcoming videos. Okay, thank you for watching.